Hey guys, welcome back. I'm running back up to the end of this area to take the lift up to Magni's Lighthouse because I had that terrible, terrible cheap death. So again, as I stated at the end of the last video, there's not a whole lot of commentary on this one because my own oversights and such, so I'll throw in a couple things here and there to explain what I'm doing or why I did what I did in a particular moment throughout this video, but for the most part, enjoy the carnage. Okay, guys?
Somewhere to place Blade's compass, and we'll find out exactly where the treasure is buried. Is it working? What's up? You did it! It looks like the treasure's buried in worm water! I'll meet you out there! My friend, and don't worry, I still need your help to get past whatever traps there might be in the treasure chamber. I will not betray you until just kidding. This honestly been a lot of fun, but this is where you die.
Software piracy eats away at the moral fabric of society. Several sand pirates have bootlegged copies of.
If it's any consolation, I meant everything I said to you. You're an awesome warrior, a real stand-up individual. But my men and I just reached the spot pointed out by the lighthouse, so this is where I say
always got new stock. Check back later.
I'll patch you up whenever you need it.
Thank you.
Now this whole stuff here, I wanted to do the Don't Copy That Floppy quest before I went and fought the Leviathan, because I wanted to go into the fight with Pimpernel, and I didn't have a specific one in mind, but I wanted either a Shock or a Slag, because I figured all around those would probably be the two that I could use the longest, because like a fire one would kind of limit me to what I could. Well, I could have probably used a fire one because there's not a whole lot of armored enemies, but I mean, if I was in a situation where there was some loaders and stuff, then the fire one wouldn't do me a whole lot of good. Conversely, the corrosive one wouldn't do me a whole lot of good against fleshies, so I figured, well, Shock kind of works against everything, and Slag just kind of same basic principle. But out of the two, I was preferred to get a Shock one, and but I would have settled on a Slag if it would have came up. Now up here, the first time I turn the quest in, it offers me a corrosive, at which point I Alt F4 out of the game, and then I'll run back up and try turning the quest in to see what it gives me. And thankfully, the second time I was pretty lucky and it offered up a Shock. Pimpernel. Might have been a Banbury? I can't remember off the top of my head. We'll have to see once we get there.
A robot can dream. Your staring is inappropriate.
So that's our little cut there where we Alt F forward. And we're going to run back up to Sensor Bot. Equip some corrosive just in case I have to fight. Try to run past everything. There was nothing there when I went through the first time to get the turn in the quest because it hadn't been long enough for the enemies to respawn.
Throwing grenade!
First model to see. First, not enters nothing.
Dandy Pimpernel, that's right. But it was shock and dream. You know, for playthrough one, you don't have to get too particular about prefixes and whatnot, so I wasn't going to keep all that foreign until I got like a barking or gentleman's. So we settled for this one. This is actually a gun too, where if you have a Maya spec'd into the Cataclysm tree, a lot of people skip chain reaction, which is dumb. Because if you end up using a gun like the Pimpernel, or even if you're using something like the Sandhawk, or anything that has multiple pellets, and you spec into a chain reaction, when it procs, you are going to have a wall of bullets flying everywhere.
If it's any consolation,
so I highly recommend if you're going to go down the Cataclysm tree, use chain reaction.
But my men and I just reached the spot pointed out by the lighthouse,
but we're
going to
go take on Scarlet and the Leviathan and raid the treasure room real quick. I don't do the second set of treasure room runs because I was going to save it for whenever I needed gear, and I just, truthfully, I just never ended up going back. Not as powerful as the Rackhive in the first game, because the pair over one clip, the Pimpernel destroys it. But in all fairness, the Pimpernel is a disgusting sniper rifle. But, this is one of them things that hurts about an Allegiance run, because I like the greed. That's one of my favorite pistols in the game, but can't use it because it's a Jacobs. So it sucks. Actually, if the Twister wasn't such a pain in the ass to get, I probably would have. Well, that and you have no shield other than the Rough Rider. I probably would have did a Jacobs run, but yeah, not having a real shield and the only shock elemental weapon you can get is the Twister. Makes that kind of rough. No accessory, Maliwan grip, so it had better proc chance for fire, but you know, for a playthrough for normal mode, not a bad greed to get through the game, but like I said, can't use it.
This is it, my friend.
And now we're gonna hit the treasure room. Legitly. I can't tell you how many times I went through here by busting in before they patched that out. For whatever reason they felt the need to do that.
So ends the story of how the Vault Hunters defeated the treacherous
Captain. Like I've said before,
Scarlet,
I don't understand why
the
they left the Nox Armory
sunset on Pandora, the Vault
unpatched, but they patched
they
this. It
Captain
just doesn't
Blade's
make sense to me
armor,
because,
the true
like, legendaries and good guns were very easy to get in the first game, whereas this game.
How was that?
That last part was really
not
hard.
So much so.
Yeah, it felt kind of contrived,
you know,
didn't it?
Extremely. But otherwise, you ended that story pretty well for a dirty little orphan.
Thanks.
Ah,
so let's
don't
see
mention
what we find
it.
In the chest.
I gotta teach somebody to tell these stories when I'm gone. Might as well be you.
Yeah. I love you, Marcus.
That's weird.
I know it doesn't affect, like, what comes out of the chest, but I always, from doing runs in here for so long, I kind of got a pattern down that I just ended up sticking with out of habit more than anything.
That is lovely. Nice.
Pew. Ooh. And I don't know where the, like, if it's rarer than others, but it seems to me that SMGs with a Maliwan barrel are actually kind of rare. Seems like, at least in this playthrough, I got a lot of Maliwan SMGs with bandit barrels for some reason. And I know it's all random and such, but just seems like the Maliwan barrel doesn't pop up as much as the other ones.
How about that? Fantastic. That is beautiful.
And I don't feel like climbing all the way back up to the top, so... And we're gonna do this.
Thank you.
low prices, and no questions asked. Remember, we're always open.
Alright, we've reached the end of the Captain Scarlet and her Pirate Booty DLC. I'm gonna go turn the quest in and then
you can always we'll wrap this the up. Gun at your side.
So, but
tear the bad guys and new
I think after this we get back into the main story. I'll double check, there might be a Headhunter pack in there somewhere. I think we did all those. Yeah, so we'll get back into the main story. But, you know, like always, guys, I want to thank everybody for watching. And we'll see you in the next one. Alright? Bye, guys.